So today what we're going to do is we're going to review the specs on some of the LED grow lights that are available on Amazon and just try to discuss some of the things that we see that are probably not quite what, you know, you would want them to be. And the two most important things to remember is the amount of light that you get and the quality of light or the color of the light. So the red, the blue, the green. We all know full spectrum is important, so it looks like a natural light, and how we get that full spectrum is really important. So we're going to optimize the red, the blue, the green for our applications, and then we're also going to compare it to some of the lights that are many of us see on Amazon. You know, those that say that they're 1200 watt lights and that they're only using 100 watts. You know, they're trying to fool you to think that the light is doing a lot more than it really is. So the first one that we're looking at is one here called a King Plus 1200 watt grow light. And the first thing I notice is that it says 1200 watts. 1200 watts is a very, very large number. So these LEDs obviously are not drawing anywhere near 1200 watts. In fact, they're probably drawing 1/10 of that amount. And in this case, the light that you see here looks like it has a lot of blue and a lot of red LEDs in it. And most likely when you turn it on, it's going to look like a burple LED, which is really what the technology was 5-6 years ago for LED grow lights. The other thing that we notice that they put on here is it's got a 10x optical condenser, which is basically an optic. So they're trying to concentrate the amount of light in a relatively small space. So one thing they don't show you on this graph is how big an area does that particular light actually cover and how high up should it be? Even though they give you values at 12 and 18 inches, those are numbers that are way too high for really growing any kind of plants that you would really want indoors. The second light that we're going to look at on Amazon today is one that's called a Grow Planer GP1500. So I think they're trying to imply that it's replacing a 1500 watt light. But one thing you'll notice with this light is that they're basically using white LEDs. In fact, if you take a look at this spectral graph, that's the signature of a white LED, and they did put a little bit of red into it as well. But a lot of these lights use these very low-cost, nickel-a-piece type white LEDs, and they'll just use a lot of them. And the problem with just using a white LED for your grow light is that it has a lot of blue in it. And that blue makes the plant short and stubby, and it doesn't give you the plant mass in order to really grow properly. So this is another example of a Chinese-type light that is sold relatively inexpensively, but it will not give you the results that you're looking for. The next light we're looking at is a company called Mars Hydro, which has actually been around a while. Again, they're implying that it is a 1,000 watt equivalent light, and it's actually using 150 watts. But if you take a look at it, again, it is using all white LEDs, which again will not give you the growth that you want. And as I mentioned earlier, you want your light to be around 60 to 70% red, 10 to 15% blue, and 20% green. So that ratio of light not only gives you a plant that looks phenomenally good, but it can give you 2.5 times or 250% more growth than just using white LEDs that a lot of these lights that are being sold on Amazon and the big box stores that are being imported from China. So that's the thing to look for, is look for levels of light that are in that 200 to 400 micromoles over the entire work area. And you want to look also at the area that you can actually plant in. That's really important. So a light that can plant in 3 by 3 feet is a light that you can grow a lot of plants in, get the level of light, and you want to get the quality of light as well. Okay, so one of the other light systems that I'm looking at here on Amazon is is one where they package a light with a box. It's a hydroponic system, and it looks really nice on the screen. But when you actually try to use it, and you have to purchase their little pods from them, you will become quickly disappointed. Typically, they don't even talk about the level of light that the system puts out. The area that you have to grow in is very small, so it's limited in what you can grow, and the plants start shading each other. So it's easy to Photoshop something that looks really good. But I can tell you, we've bought some of these systems before and actually tried them, and it's very, very awkward, and it doesn't work very well. And it sounds like it's running because there's little pumps motors running inside the system all the time. So I would steer clear of something like this, because I think you would quickly find that it doesn't do what you'd like for it to do. The main takeaway I'd like for you to walk away with from this short video is look for someone who can help you educate you on how to grow indoors using their lights. I think one of the things that we've seen is that there's a lot of lights you can pick and choose from, but you don't know really how to use them. So here at Happy Leaf, our goal is to educate you. Get on our YouTube channel, look at our videos, buy our book called Grow Lettuce in Your Living Room. Our lights were designed for you to be able to quickly and easily become a green thumb on anything you want to grow, because they give you the right amount of light and the right quality of light. And if you do that with very simple instructions, you'll be able to successfully grow not only some of your own food at home, but your flowers, your succulents, whatever you'd like to grow. There's no magic to it. It's just knowing how to do it, and we're here to help you figure that out. So remember to like, subscribe, and share to our YouTube channel. Please come back again.